What is up, guys? Welcome back to PU Land. This time I'm bringing you a battle against someone by the name of PikaFTW321. His team is a mix of PU and NU pokes, and overall is quite serious looking, so naturally I decided to bring some threatening stuff as well. You know, like an Electro Ball Raichu, Raised Hydration Shelmet, Offensive Rain Dance Pelipper, and a Choice Bandit Fred. Let's see how it went down. I lead with Maggie to do some magic, like setting up a magic screen on my side. I set up light screen on a switch to Leiron, and then a reflect as he toxics me. Seeing a toxic, I think this is more defensive Leiron variant, and with a reflect up, he won't do much to my Meganium, so I just stay in and go for a Giga Drain as he sets his rocks up. It does a solid chunk, so knowing that I'm at better position in that matchup, I remove my status with Aromatherapy and take a head smash very nicely. Seeing that this doesn't work out for him, my opponent switches to Troch and takes a Giga Drain much better, which tells me right away that he's probably a bulk up variant with a max special defense investment. So I switch to Terra Quack, predicting his bulk up on the switch, knowing that even with max special defense he won't appreciate taking a stab Life Orb Hurricane. Instead, he goes for a Silker Throw though and brings my Shelmet in. I decide to use that, set up a Rain Dance and toxic him because Reflect Up on my side makes up for his guts, and in the rain I should be able to rest stall him. He bulks up once, Circle throws me and brings in my Raichu. Knowing that Electro Ball won't take him out from this range, I switch back to Shelmet, but he makes a very good play and goes for another bulk up predicting that. I rest off the damage so that I will be able to survive another Stealth Rock switching, meanwhile he Circle throws again and this time drags out my
Cocainum.
Now here is the interesting bit. Thanks to Furet's Dream Mode ability, Frisk, I find out that he's holding a Chesto Berry, and that confirms my suspicions about him being a standard Smogon Resto Chesto variant. So I actually run the calcs right there to see if I will be able to take him out with a Choice Bandit Double Edge, but unfortunately I forgot to include plus 2 defense into account, so it does nowhere as much as I expected and he takes me out with another Silker Throw, so I stupidly lost my late game sweeper. But at least toxic damage takes him out as well, so that's one major threat out of the way. Anyway, I go back to Meganium, and unless his Z-Striker has choice specs, I think I can survive unstabbed overheat, so I just go for Giga Drain to do some good damage to him. He misses his attack, and because Giga Drain looks to be a 3-hit KO, he decides to switch back to Leiron, but still takes it only a little bit better. Moreover, that allows me to set up screens again, on the turns he toxics me and roars me out to Shelmet. At this point I decided to leave this thing to die, so I just stay in, but would you look at that, Shelmet takes super effective stab base 150 attack like a monster, so because of that I change my mind, save this thing as a death fodder for later and switch to Marauder to take another one. He either predicts that or just randomly switches his move and unfortunately rolls me right back to Shelmet, which dies to a Stealth Rock damage. So now I go to Marauder again and I was really close to going for an Iron Head. But just in case he decides to leave this thing and keep shuffling my team, I go for an Earthquake instead. That play really costs me because he predicts that and gets a safe switch to Solrak. Now that wouldn't be a big deal, but his Solrak turns out to be a Rock Polish Baton Pass variant, so before I know it I'm facing a Golark with plus 2 speed, and let me tell you, that's never a good sign. So right there he gets a little dynamic punch sweep going on, brings my Leiron very low on health and takes out Meganium as well as Pelipper. But then, to our both surprise, my Raichu outspeeds him even at plus 2 like a G6 and takes out with Hidden Power Eyes. Had I known that, I wouldn't lose half of my team. Anyway, he switches back to Leiron and I go for a Crook's move of the set, Electro Ball. It just misses the kill, but for some reason rather than hit me with Head Smash, he decides to roar me out to my own Leiron. Now I go for a Head Smash predicting a switch to Zangoose, but it misses, he stays in and finishes me off with Head Smash of his own. It makes no difference though, because now I go back to Raichu and revenge kill him with Electro Ball, and because I'm holding a Metronome, another Electro Ball is powered up a bit, and it may be because of that his Solrak also doesn't survive it. But then he brings his Zangoose, and because most of these things in 5th gen have Toxic Boost, I set up an Agility predicting him to Protect to activate the Toxic Orb. He confirms to have Toxic Boost by going for a Facade, but even without Toxic it turns out to be enough to take me out, and that is the game. Good game pick up for the win, with a few hacks, but overall I think they didn't make much of a difference, and you won because you played better. If you guys enjoyed the battle, don't forget to leave a like, check out my opponent's channel, and I see you all next time.